In this tutorial, I'll show you how to animate the camera's depth of field. In this example, the depth of field is focused on the small cube that's following a path. We can hide the path and the cube to have a smooth transition. This method can be utilized to give a special blurry feeling to the scene, and it can be used for still image shots as well. I'll create a few basic primitives and align their Z axis with the world center. I'm typing G, Z, and 1 to do so. G and Y to move on the Y axis. G and X to move on the X axis. Shift Z to wireframe view. Lastly, I'll create a ground plane. S to scale. In edit mode, type 2 to edge select. Select this edge and control B to bevel with the mouse wheel up a few times. Right click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. Let's auto smooth the meshes. To animate the depth of field, we need two more objects. Let's create a curve point. If you don't see the curve point, please activate an extra objects add-on. In edit mode, E to extrude. When the extrusion is complete, please type A to select all, and type V and A to smooth them. Normally, we would use an empty object as the depth of field reference object, but we can't animate it along the curve. I'll use a small cube to do so, but using constraints like this. If we use the small cube as the reference object, then we can animate the depth of field. This is how we animate the depth of field. I have found how to melt the scene like this by using another method. Do you see how there's a limit to the f-stop setting there? I have found if I use an empty object to focus the depth of field, and move the object away from the meshes, the scene will melt. I have found that accidentally, and the melting method can be used to create very creative and cool looking 3D animation that looks 2D. Here is the result of the first depth of field animation. I'll open a saved file from yesterday and show you the melting effect. This is from my practice run, and I was animating an empty object to move closer or away from the meshes. I found if I move the empty object that is being used as a depth of field reference object away from the scene, the melting effect will occur. I'm using a basic animation to move the empty object away like this. This is the result. I've never seen anything like this, and it can be used to create an awesome-looking abstract background animation for various projects. Please experiment with the effect, and I feel it would look even better with emission shaders. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.